in zu mein zu meinen Namen. Heibo, in zu mein zu meinen Namen.
How Hippo lost his tail. One day, as Elephant was nibbling juicy leaves from the top of a tall tree, Hare came hopping along.
Hello there, Elephant.
Hello, Hare. What are you going to do with that rope in your hand?
Oh, I brought it along for our competition.
A competition? What kind of competition do you have in mind?
A competition to find out who is the strongest, you or I. You must hold on to this end of the rope, and I'll hold on to the other end. The one that can pull the other one over the hill is the winner.
Really, Hare? How silly you are. I'm much bigger and stronger than you. Of course I'll win.
You might. Then again, you might not.
He gave Elephant one end of the rope to hold in her trunk.
Now listen carefully, Elephant. I'm going to the other side of the hill. As soon as I call out, pull! You must pull with all your might.
With the other end in his paw, he ran over the hill until he came to Hippo.
Hello there, Hippo. Hello, Hare. And what are you doing with that rope in your hand?
Oh, I need this for our competition.
Our competition? What competition?
A competition to find out who's the strongest, you or I. You must hold on to this end of the rope, and I'll hold on to the other end. The winner is the one who can pull the other one over the hill.
How silly you are, Hare. I'm much bigger and stronger than you are. Of course I'll win.
You might. Then again, you might not.
He gave Hippo his end of the rope to hold in his mouth.
Now listen carefully, Hippo. I'm going to the other side of the hill. As soon as I call out, pull! You must pull for all your worth.
Hare turned and ran as fast as he could to the top of the hill. There he hid behind a thick bush. Then he shouted as loudly as he could,
pull!
On her side of the hill, Elephant pulled with all her might. And on his side, Hippo did the
Good
same.
Heavens! I never knew that Hare was so strong.
Wow! I didn't know that Hare was so strong.
Elephant pulled harder. So did Hippo. Elephant gave a mighty heave, huffing and puffing. So did Hippo. Then Elephant used every bit of strength she had. And with a roar, she pulled Hippo over the hill.
Oh!
It's you! You tricked me!
That was a sneaky Hare. He tricked us both.
But Elephant did not listen to Hippo. She rushed towards him, trumpeting loudly. Hippo waddled away as fast as he could. But Elephant caught up with him. She grabbed Hippo's tail, gave him a mighty pull, and off it came. Take a look at these two today. Elephant still has a longish tail, while Hippo only has a short stump. The two of them don't speak to each other at all, and they are certainly not friends with Hare.
I'm so mad.